16-13 Justin Rose is really flying now. He has just hit the first ever Olympic hold in 1-16-12, but as one sport ends, another begins. Over to the badminton. At least it is scheduled to begin. It's the first day of the badminton at the Rio Olympics, and women's doubles are due to start with British pair Heather Oliver and Lauren Smith in action in a group match against Malaysia. 16-01 Switzerland take gold medal in the lightweight men's four final. I say very shortly because there is one more gold medal news to bring you from the Lagoa Stadium. Switzerland have taken gold in the lightweight men's four final, with Denmark taking silver and France claiming bronze. That's all the medals done for the day in the rowing. 15-57 Geringer and Thornley look happy enough with their silver medal, and so they should. To read a full report on their silver medal success, although click here, as we will be departing the rowing very shortly. Victoria Thornley, Wright, and Catherine Graner salute the crowd after taking silver medal. Granger and Thornley defied many expectations to win silver in the women's double sculls in Rio. 15-52 Danny Willett and Justin Rose have now both got underway in the golf. Willett is currently 2 under, while Rose is on par in the first round, which is currently being led by Marcus Fraser of Austria, who is 6 under par. Great Britain's Danny Willett plays a shot during the first round of the golf in Rio. Justin Rose is also in action in the first golf competition at the Olympics since 1904. 15-45 Natalie Powell reaches the quarterfinals in the women's minus 78 kilograms judo. We've not had a huge dose of good British news this afternoon, but there is a splash of it over in the judo, as Natalie Powell has defeated Sarah Miriam Mazouz of Gabon by a pawn to reach the quarterfinal. She will face Audrey Tumio of France next, who took bronze at London 2012. Natalie Powell of Great Britain defeated Sarah Miriam Mazouz of Gabon during her last 16 match in the judo minus 78 kilograms. 15-36 Brilliant from Croatia, you win gold medal in the men's double sculls. Although Lithuania moved ahead, the Sinkovic brothers of Martin and Valent responded magnificently to edge back in front and take gold. Lithuania win silver while Norway take the bronze. Britain picked France to avoid finishing last as they come a distant fifth. Johnny Walton and John Collins of Great Britain picked France to claim fifth in the final. 15-35 into the final 500 meters, and Lithuania have edged in front. Croatia were looking strong and were favorites for this final, but they have fell behind to Lithuania. Norway remain third. Britain are on France's tail for fifth. 15-34 at the halfway stage, Britain look well out of medal contention now. Meanwhile out in front, favorites Croatia still lead in front of Lithuania, with Norway now third. 15-32 after 500 meters, Britain are bringing up the field. Walton and Collins were an outside shot of a medal, and they are struggling in the early stages. Croatia from Lithuania and France hold the medals at this stage. 15-29 now it's the men's turn in the double sculls rowing final. Johnny Walton and John Collins feature Team GB. Can they now grab a medal? Away we go. 15-28 consolation for Granger. That silver medal has put her in British sporting history. The Scot is now Great Britain's most successful female Olympian, taking silver at Sydney, Athens, Beijing and Rio, with of course a stunning gold at London 4 years ago. 15-24 from British Olympic rowing champion Matthew Pinn sent on Twitter, brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. One of the most amazing at Team GB stories this year. Thornley, Granger silver. Matthew Pinn sent. At Matthew Pinn sent. August 11, 2016. 15-23 A quick update in the dressage as Team GB hold third place in the equestrian. Team GB hash equestrian dressage looking slick. Sat in third behind hash Duradollar hash Ned with a haster dressage dollar extra Jordan to go. Picked out twitter.com web link, Team GB, at Team GB, August 11, 2016. 15-20 Here are the final results of the women's double sculls final as Britain takes silver. It must be stressed, Granger came out of retirement 2 years ago following the London 2012 success. And following poor results this season, no one really gave her and Thornley much chance to medal at these games. Being pipped to gold is a bitter pill to swallow, but silver is still a superb result. Catherine Granger and Victoria Thornley just missed out on a gold medal in the women's double sculls. 15-15 Poland take gold medal in the women's double sculls ahead of Britain. Granger and Thornley may have just missed out on gold, but after a poor season, silver medal is still a terrific result. It won't feel like that now, of course, though, as Poland pipped them to gold, their first of the Rio 2016 Olympics. Lithuania grab bronze. 15-14 There are 500 meters to go and Britain still lead. And it's still a narrow margin over Poland. It's between these two countries for gold, with Lithuania still in third. 15-12 At the halfway mark, Britain retain a narrow lead over Poland. Now it's getting interesting. Britain and Poland are way out in front, with Lithuania a couple of seconds back in third. 15-10 Great Britain lean after the first 500 meters. Positive signs, but it means very little at this stage, especially with Poland and France right on their tail in the first 500 meters. 15:08 The women's double sculls final is about to get underway. Granger and Thornley will go for gold, but that does look like a slim chance. A medal though is a real possibility, especially after the strong semi-final.